Thank you, Hannah. Musicians, singers, amen. I'm going to ask our Master Search Committee to come and join me here on the platform and with all of our elders and leaders who have been a part of this. Come on up here and join me at this time. Amen. Bill Cofer has headed this group up for us, and I'm going to turn it over, the mic over to him right now.
Well, I want to present to you this morning our new senior pastor, Pastor Mark Linton. So I want you to take my name off the table and go ahead and consider others. And we did. We considered a total of 14 people, all fine people, fine men of God. But we could not settle on that one. And just a few weeks ago, the Holy Spirit turned our attention back to Pastor Mark Linton. And he was able to share with us that God had moved in a decisive way in his heart and life, and he was now free to pursue the position of senior pastor. So in just a few days after that, we called Pastor Mark to be our new senior pastor, and at the same time, we called Pastor Mark Anthony Linton to be our new executive pastor. Praise the Lord.
Been one of our pastors here for 28 years. So I think he has had time for us to get to know him. Okay. 2.5 years ago, he moved over from being youth pastor to being our associate pastor, and he's done a tremendous job. And then Mark Anthony stepped up as our youth pastor. Mark Anthony is a graduate of the University of Georgia with a degree in marketing, and he has proven himself with many administrative skills. We're going to call him the executive pastor, but we used to call him administrative pastor. And it will be administration and pastoral duties that he'll have here. But we did look all over the place. And then the Lord said, look, the best for you in this church is right here. Yes. Amen? So it was such an honor for us to turn back to Pastor Mark Linton and say, the Lord has shown us you're the pastor. Amen? So praise the Lord. And Mark Anthony as his executive pastor to work with him in administrative here in the church. And so we celebrate, right? Woo! Yes. pastor emeritus, that means pastor old man who doesn't have much to do anymore, right? I think I've been here long enough, 45 years, that's probably. Amen. Today, it's going to be 2 weeks from today, on May the 20th, Sunday, Pentecost Sunday. We've been preaching, the three of us, Journey to Pentecost, and on that day, we'll conclude it with this presentation as we bring them down with their families and lay hands on them and set them in as the pastors of this church. That will be on the 20th of May, okay? All right, so 2 weeks from today. Next Sunday is Mother's Day, and then the next Sunday after that. Amen. Pastor, welcome.
Amen. First of all, let me just say, I'm humbled. I've served you and love serving you. I couldn't imagine anywhere else I'd rather be a group of people that I would love and honor and respect, and it is a joy to be here, and it always has for 28 years. It's never been a burden. I've never felt like, oh gosh, I need to go. Maybe you felt that way, but I never did. Maybe I caused it, I don't know, maybe some have. But I'm telling you, there's a love, and the reason I didn't want to just jump into something is I know as soon as Pastor Lincoln mentioned that, I saw every one of you. As soon as he mentioned it came from here, everybody went, every one of y'all kept going, like, look, and I appreciate that. That was a joy, but I had to go, y'all are going this way, and I'm going, okay, Lord, what are you saying? And so I just want to tell you what a joy and honor it is to have the confidence and the clarity of saying, God, I get to stand on a man's shoulders that has built such a firm foundation. Yeah. And by the grace of God, I get to take the next step that this church, the next part, the next leg of the journey, more, but God, it's a passing of a baton. And when he says he's stepping down, he ain't stepping anywhere. He's stepping aside, but he's not stepping away. And we've got a saddle, I mean an office. That we're still. He's still going to be right here, and that's the joy. I'm telling you, that's one of the strengths that I have and the confidence I have of knowing that he's right here with me, and that he knows all my faults and shortcomings and weaknesses. And man, he is just gracious and wonderful. And so we get to walk this together still. We get to switch a little bit of roles, but it's good. He keeps asking me, this is what do you want me to do, Pastor? I'm like, I don't know. So,
well, starting the 20th of this month, you're my pastor. Amen. You are my pastor. And we're going to honor you and hold you up and pray for you every day, Pastor. You're my pastor. All right, amen.
Amen.
So I'm going to go sit down.
Amen. You have a seat. And he's going to be my pastor, too. I don't care. You're not going. Amen. Y'all, I guess we'll go. I don't know. You got it. Thank you, dear Lord. It's like, okay, where I go next. Okay, here we go.